Greetings, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to the Azores of a still unknown planet. I am der Heizmeister, and this is the second part of the construction video of the Britgun. Or, you know, the high-volume kinetic ducker throwing equipment would be another way to say it. So then, leaving my submarine alone for a moment, this is the current state of this gun emplacement. I have finished constructing the outer shell and added the first missile decoys to it, alongside some missile interceptors, and this episode will be finishing up the upper plate here of this emplacement, as well as the gun house, and armoring the turret neck a little bit more, and then fine-tuning the inner mechanisms of this defensive structure. And afterwards we will be doing some fun things, live firing tests, with different types of ammunition, by the way. Okay, let's get started. And the first procedure that has to be done is to once again cut away this temporary placement of the firing pieces and the gun barrels here, and extend the turret neck a little bit upwards and create a little bit of a platform on which to place the gun house. So before we do this, always make sure to have a prefab of this thing, since this will also save the settings in each firing piece, and saves me a lot of work afterwards. Okay, this has to be the entire length. And do it. Okay, it has been copied. Please ignore the laser targeters for now. I, of course, planned to use this gun with a pure kinetic payload. However, those laser targeters will come in very handy later on when we'll be doing the live fire testing and testing a little bit of different ammunition types on this gun. Because I found out together with Razul that there are more options you can use on these kind of Brit guns other than pure kinetic warheads. Although with belt-fed autoloaders you lose the chance of having ejectors on them, since ejectors do not work with belt-fed autoloaders, meaning that if you use any kind of chemical warhead, like frag or high explosive, or even frag, this gun will become the most expensive powder keg the world has ever seen. So, how high do I want to have this? Let's see, there is going to be a ring here, and then there is one. This means two, and placing the gun here, yeah, that would be fine. I don't want to make this turret too high. It is already a, how would I put it? Big chungus, and that is a technical term for this. So, don't want to mess up the proportions after all. Then, placing the gun, and voila, we have our firing pieces back and our saved settings. Gauge is correct, yes, absorption doesn't look too well. However, this should be no problem. I should be able to increase this recoil absorption a little bit by continuing to place recoil absorbers all the way up here. Maybe not. Okay. Oh yeah, totally forgot. Laser targeters. And now there's an uneven number of recoil absorbers in here. Well, we can't have that. Yeah, that's all right. let's go with this. Okay, then. Turret ring. First of all, the neck has to be extended. And armored a little bit more. What kind of block do I have here? Oh, this one. So, upwards we go. And let's not forget sides as well. And... oh yeah, there's apparently such a feature called mirror mode. One would be wise to enable it when building. It appears I am not the one, though. Hmm. Yep. Need to think a bit about this. Okay, then. Looks like this the part here is finished. This may look a little bit rough right now, and for one reason, I just need to have the rough outline on where to place this additional armor belt here, and I will now finish up the gun house and then add the details later. At least this is the plan for now. Okay, how would I put this? The most important bit here is to make sure that mirror mode is enabled, so that any amount of frustration experienced while building should be minimized. Okay. Yeah, I want to have a belt of heavy armor around this gun, making sure that it is well protected. And this should also help in minimizing any explosive creep, meaning that explosions can sometimes seep in to these unprotected parts of the gun, which is not wanted, actually. This is pretty much something to avoid. Okay. Yeah, I know, this looks a little bit rough and unrefined, but please bear with me for now. Bye-bye, recoil absorbers. Please bear with me for now. This will be cleaned up later. Okay, so I could put a 2-meter beam in here. However, I will use two heavy armor blocks to get a little bit of an armor bonus. Actually, while I'm building, I should probably switch from my... what are they called? Binoculars to the armor mode. 72. Oh, looks alright. Yeah, it's alright. So, this has now been encased in heavy armor. I could add a little bit more. However, this gun will then become... this gun house will then become a lot more sturdy, especially here at the front. However, it will get quite large. Here's the question. How much of a chunky gun house I would like to construct? Now, this... I don't want to have this look like some kind of a big turret body with a small gun house. This would look ridiculous. Kind of like a super buff person with a tiny head. So let's see. Let's go for my standard, very much uninspired box turret for now and see if I can refine this design a little bit further in the process here. Alrighty. This is looking more like it. A gunhouse and detection equipment have been placed so far. And decorations will be added at a later point in time, I need to extend this. What do you call this? Is this the barbette? Yeah, it looks fine so far. However, there is one issue I have seen here. This coincidence rangefinder does not have that much armor on top of it. Which may not be the best solution for this, but yeah, I just take it anyway, I guess. This visual camera will always point towards the target, so it should have enough space to do so in here. The inner mechanism of this gun is well encased inside heavy armor. Now, about this recoil absorption we were talking about, looks like it's a little bit worse than it was before. I have deleted these recoil absorbers that were sitting on top of here. There's not much I can do about it now. Ah, whatever. I'll take it. I'll take it. I have to get finished at some point. I mean, I have to get it done at least. Yeah, applique armor. I mean, I would like to put this down here, but then I fear that this visual camera, this tracker, would not be able to pick up any target that is right here and right here, just in a straight line in front of it. I mean, yeah, let's look at it like this. This gun will always turn to its primary target. Makes sense, and therefore the tracker should always point towards the primary target. Still. I know I could have armored this rangefinder a little bit better, with decorations and these portholes. These allow visual detections to be put through. However, nah, I choose not to do it for reasons that are yet unknown to me. Now, at this point in the building process, I noticed that this gun now costs 327,000 materials, and well, some of you may ask yourselves now at this point, why? Why build such a thing? Or for what purpose? The answer is simple. When it comes to bridge, thou shalt not ask why, thou shalt only ask how many. So, words of wisdom have been dispensed. Let's continue the building process. I need to finish this rather soon. Actually, is there... Yep, there's still some space in here. Okay, lovely, lovely, lovely. This has been finished, and let's make this a little bit prettier here. So I use this, and... Oh, that looks good. And how about these? How about not? Besides, while we're on the topic of why even bother building such an inefficient construct, it's simple, really. It's fun. And that's what matters for the moment for me. It's a very fun build, and I can also reuse this whole turret as a base for other guns and equally large defensive emplacements. So, you know, there's nothing is wasted here. Nothing is wasted at all. This level of material cost, you have to admit. We are getting into the territory of... yeah. Why? Why even do it? Because it's Brit. That's why. Okay. Adding a little bit more armor here and there to make it all look very neat and tidy. Oh, these missiles are now in a small pocket and a little bit more protected than they were before. And one of these, and one of these, and maybe a little bit of this. Haha! Finished. Yeah. Yep, I like this a lot. A little bit could be done here as well. Actually, hang on a moment. Oh, how does this look? Please give me your honest opinion. I have thought of a way to integrate detection components into the main structure. They are a little bit exposed, however, but I will not drop a bunch of portholes on this just to armor up my 360-degree trackers. This would look silly at this moment. So yeah, laser rangefinders will be added here and here as well. Is this the same? That's the it's the same distance. All right. Though it seems like I have forgotten to. Oh no, it's all right. Ah, never mind. So, laser rangefinders in here, and while we're on the topic of defense. Some munition warners wouldn't go amiss in here. Yep. This looks actually quite alright. In terms of further detection, I will add a sensor tower with all my defensive buildings. And this sensor tower provides a wide range of detection options and is equipped with an inter-vehicle transmitter in order to transmit the detection information to other vehicles. At this point, I of course realize that I could outfit every one of my defensive structures with an inter-vehicle transmitter, and fear not, I have done so. Since when it comes to defenses here, I do like the concept of teamwork, all those defenses working together as one giant resource-hungry investment. I may not sound that convinced of this structure here, but believe me, I am. I'm looking very much forward to see it in action. Alright, here's an idea. I used this mesh you can find on the a simple weapon grenade launcher called Grenade Gatling or something like that, and I wanted to have this on a spin block and basically rotate when the gun is firing. I do realize that these casings here are not the same size as the gun barrel. Yes, but please bear with me here. I'm trying to have this as a mimic on a spin block and only enable this when the gun is actually firing. I mean, this is alright. This could work. But how does it look? Idiot. But how does it look on here, maybe? This would take away some armor from this rangefinder. Might not be the best choice, but let's test this for a moment. So, that's just an idea. It came to me just now. Let me just please copy this, copy the decoration, thank you, and add another spin block on the other side of this. And I want to look at it when it rotates. just get a kind of feeling of the aesthetics and how this would look. I mean, it's all right. Maybe have some kind of exit here, and it's a shame that I cannot mimic any discarded shells falling out of this gun. But still. Ah. Yeah, maybe have it a little bit more to the side, more outwards, to right and left respectively. And smaller. This could work. This could maybe work. However, let's see how it does. Okay then, spin rage, please spin. Ah, come on. Eight radians per second. This is reversed, so that this needs to be continuous. 8 radians per second. Oh god. Actually, not bad. Not bad at all, I think. Having fun with decorations. I never thought I would say that. Yeah, let me think about it a little bit more and refine the design, and then I'll be right back. I promise. Now, this does look like an ammo feed, doesn't it? You know what? I'm thinking about it. This decoration is in the middle, placed in the middle of this spin block, and since it's very round, it has one root point it rotates around and looks quite nice. Now, I want to add some, maybe some end caps here, so that this looks more like shells or, well, an ammunition feeding system. Here's the question though. If I place those correctly, all, I don't know how many those are. A lot. All shells around the spin block, would they rotate correctly if they are offset like this? Let's think for a moment. They are in the middle and then offset like this. They should rotate correctly, and if I place them just right so that the tip, the warhead, the bullet is now placed on the end of this, they should rotate in unison with this ammunition belt here. Is it worth it putting all this effort into some decoration? I haven't even thought about making it rotate when the gun fires. Yes, it is. Let's do this. I'll be right back though, so I won't have you sit through me adding all these decorations on there. No, that would be, oh god, that would be horror. No. Preliminary testing of this whole system. There needs to be something obscuring the ammunition feed here, and something in there as well. But I think this looks all right. Yeah, I'm strangely pleased with myself right now. Now, on to add 32 of those bullets. Fun. Yeah, I know. It is not an exact replica of a Sabo shell. Please bear with me here. I used the simple mimic cone command. You can insert in the search bar. Just type mimic in there, and then different shapes will be available for you. So this here is a cone, and this is how it's going to look. And this should be all right when turning. The moment of truth approaches. Wow. Wait, no, slow down, please. That's too fast. yeah, the other way around, but still. It works. just 63 more. I'll be sitting here for a while. There we go. Last bit of decoration placed, and no, I couldn't have used mirror mode. Some my suggested in the comments that, oh, mine just do half of it, like 10 out of 20. Oh, looks like I miscounted there earlier. 20, I mean 10 of those, and apply mirror mode, and then this works. No, it doesn't. And I do select apply mirror mode. Those 10 will be applied. However, as soon as I exit this window, the other half will be deleted. So you have to set them all up manually. All right, now the most important thing. Copy all those. And before anything happens, Brit for the World has been saved. Good, now. Stop spinning for now. I just have to figure out how to get these things to spin when the gun is being fired. Okay, let's do this. Delete all, yes. Paste all, yes. Ha! I can't believe that worked. Okay. How do you rotate? You should rotate a little bit differently. Continuously reverse, and then go, yeah, in there. Let's have this go at 3 per second. Yeah, that looks good. I can live with this. There we go. Yeah, you rotate continuous. And spinning up. this is so much better. Yeah. Let's be honest, the caliber is slightly different than from the gun barrels, but hey. This is perfect. Now, the thing I have planned here is to set the spin rate to one channel. Custom axis. No, not this one. Miscellaneous. Yes, let's be A for ammo. Okay. And you as well go A for ammo. Alright then. So much effort for something like this. How to make it spin? I'll figure something out. I mean, how to make it spin only when the gun fires. I am now in the setup or the interface of a normal breadboard accessible from the controls tab, not the AI one. And in there is a new input, an event input, meaning that I can see event APS fired. APS shells have been fired. The value is the diameter of the shells that have been fired. Interesting. This means I can check for any shells fired, and this means this spin block should also begin spinning. Energy send projectile has been noticed. Ah, interesting. I might have to look into this. Pulse laser. Yeah, for now, APS. The time between checks. Let's see if I can come up with something rather simple. I just need APS fired. Yes, no. If yes, then where is it? Accumulator. No, drives. There it is. Main, primary, tertiary. Wait, what? No? I see. Problems. Alright then, I hope you can hear me. I have now set up this shell feed system, and this pitbot is now turning. However, not at a continuous speed, rather it will turn every time an APS shell has been fired, which is, yeah, well, kind of logical, isn't it? As you can see here. Yeah. So, while the press port is a little bit spazzing out, it works. Somehow, at least. It does work. The pedal gun back there is invincible, by the way. I just wanted to test this system. Now, let's see if I can adjust it a little bit better. But, it does what I wanted to. Not bad. Okay. I know. I'm not the best when it comes to breadboards. Yeah, please bear with me here. But for now, I have achieved success. The spin blocks are spinning rather nicely. Actually, they are spinning at the firing speed of the gun. So it looks like every time a shell is fed in here, it's at the same point when a shell is fired. So this works. And once it stops spinning. There we go. It works. I'm very happy about this, actually. I can't believe it. Before you ask, yes, this is definitely going up on the workshop once I've refined the design a little bit more and iron out some flaws. But yeah. this will probably get blown off once a cram shell hits it, but that's it. So, with this being finished, for now, at least, well, functionally finished, I think you know what that means. Live firing testing. Let me just prepare something. So, the first target will be kinetic sable, basically the standard ammunition of this one, against a trebuchet. And there we go. Firing rather nicely. Spin blocks working as well. I love it. And here is the trebuchet. Now, you see a lot of bounces here and there. This would be most likely due to the shields that the trebuchet has. However, the sheer amount of firepower that is coming this way will sooner or later make its way through the trebuchet and annihilate its insides. And there we go. First gun detonated. And now it's all over. Second gun detonated. And this should probably be it. No? Maybe not then. Okay. And third gun detonated. Nice. Yeah, this is kinetic sable. Basically, the go-to ammunition I have chosen for this particular setup. And missiles being distracted by decoys. Everything working as intended. Alright then, so much for the trebuchet. Now, next I will show you the trick of giving an eerie, how should I put it, component dysentery. Well, there we go. The eerie has been spawned, the shell has been changed, and the shell this time is this little thing here. Armor piercing, solid, and a little bit of shaped charge secondary, a little bit of heat damage. An unusual combination. Razul and I found out that during our testing, this particular shell was surprisingly useful. Anyway, let's test this against this eerie. And yeah, immediately we can see why I call this the the component dysentery shell. An unpleasant feeling this is. No. sorry. Please bear in mind that the high explosive filler in this shell makes it especially volatile. It might play some clips. But I think this shell very much serves its purpose. Yeah. Okay, granted, the Eerie is not yet destroyed, yeah. This is not the outright killer or rock destroyer shell. I mean, it destroys Buck Jester. It hollows it out a bit. But yeah, component dysentery. Nasty, nasty, nasty. Next one, please. And here it is. Next up, we have Armor Piercing Head, Flak, and Time Fuse. I did promise you that there would be a time when we could fill Flak shells into a Brit gun, after all. And I delivered. So, Tracer, Time Fuse, Flak, Armor Piercing. Yeah, there is a reason why I added those laser rangefinders to this. And our opponent will be 15 flying squirrels. I just leave the camera at this and let you enjoy the show. Yep, yep. And come on, select the target. And you're gone, you're gone. And you cannot escape. Try to run away, but nope. Blitz is faster.
Job's done.
Yeah. Black plus Brit equals fun. Now for the last part. For this last showcase of ammunition types, I have added a simple frag shell. Basically removed replaced the time fuse with an inertial fuse and replaced Flak with frag and left the armor piercing head. So, fragment cone angle is at 135 degrees, and our opponent for this last testing round is a Mobula. Make no mistake, if this turret gets hit and the armor does get pierced, and even one clip gets destroyed, or even one autoloader, the chain reaction will rip apart the insides of this turret when loading Flak Head. Razul and I have found this out in our testing. Depending on your hardware setup, this may or may not crash your computer. Or, well, depending how moody From the Depths is, it seems to change from day to day. Anyway, let the Brit commence. Frag shells impacting on this air cruiser and not doing a whole lot just yet. Well, I say this, but yeah. 1 meter mantlets, by the way. that's a problem with those. And there we go. Continue. Yeah. This is an interesting shell indeed. While the former, or my first, giving the eerie dysentery, was some kind of blender shell, this one is rather like a sand blaster with all those frag warheads. Not very effective at shielded or basically armored targets, but still. A good all-rounder. And it does indeed get through. And one wing of the Mobula has been clipped. Oh, almost clipped. This thing is surprisingly sturdy and stable in the air. I have to admit. I did not expect that with such a large aircraft and considering this has such a large wingspan as well. There goes the particle accelerator cannon. Needless to say that for this test I had to turn my little spam gun there invincible and enable God mode. But yeah. This is it. Mobula is now what should I say? A flying wing type aircraft. simple laser. I hate this noise. The howling makes it even worse. Yes, eat away. Eat the ammunition and spew it at the target. And have we won yet? Yeah, I'm pretty sure we have. So yeah, I hope you have enjoyed this little construction series of something else. A Brit gun with animated ammunition feed. Haha. yeah, for the next weekend I will be setting up another poll again and we will most likely construct something else. Something more different than a simple gun turret. Just wait for the surprise. Anyway, I hope you've enjoyed this. Expect this thing fairly soon on the workshop. Wednesday next week, maybe. Don't quote me on that. And yeah, I hope I see you next time on the Azure Seas of an unknown planet when the defense initiative will go into the next round. Take care and goodbye. Brit for the world.